الإنسان إنسان
Ever pursued to the Shmaya. We have the Nair in the background, and Baruch Hashem. Tomorrow, let's fire it up. There's a big one. So, Atfila B'Shem Kol Yisrael. This is a big one. Master of the world, Master of the world, grant us complete faith. You know the challenges that the entire world is experiencing in regard to faith, which is the foundation of everything. And particularly, the holy Jewish people are experiencing such challenges. The Jewish people are all believers and children of believers. However, there are tens of thousands of levels of faith. At present, all the troubles and exiles that the Jewish people are experiencing result from a blemish in their faith, which is the foundation of the entire Torah, as revealed to us through your holy sages. In particular, at present, you have sent forth your wrath so that a number of evil anti-Jewish decrees have been passed into law, including the conscription of young Jews who are sent into battle. Mamish Maisa Shebechol Yom. It's happening right now. Rav Nachman is actually speaking the words of right now. We are broken and our wounds fester. What has happened to us? Who will stand on our side at the troubled and bitter time? To where will we flee for help? And now we hear that even harsher decrees against the Jewish people, Jewish religion, are being contemplated. All these Jewish troubles have resulted from a blemish in our faith. What can we do to rectify this, particularly ourselves, for we have sinned against you so much? Certainly this is all the result of a flaw in faith, which is the foundation of the entire Torah. To end off, sin and lack of faith are dependent on each other because we have sinned so much, our faith is not whole. And because of our lack of faith, we have sinned. How do we begin to rectify this? Leaving off with a question, B'siyata D'Shmaya, and Aseres Yemei Teshuva. B'ezrat Hashem, today we're going to learn what it means to give Hashem pleasantness in a place of distance. Ikar, and by the way, you'll have to help with the Hebrew because the Hebrew is not great. Ikar gedulaso shekadosh baruch hu who should gam harchokim imenu yisparach meod meod gam him yiskarvu la'avodato. So the greatness of HaKadosh Baruch Hu is that HaKadosh Baruch Hu mamish treasures and loves and comes close to the people and to the avoda that is seemingly far on the outside. Where the people think they're far, they're distant, they have no connection to Hashem, they don't belong in the same sentence as Hashem, chas v'shalom. They're not a child of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, chas v'shalom. Hashem specifically with those people draws super, super close and cherishes their avoda. Me'od, me'od, says Rabbi Nachman. U'bazen is yakir v'nis ala shemo yisbarach l'malo mata. Why? Because these people are able to increase Hashem's name and his will and his honor and his greatness through the highs and the lows. This is playing off the last piece that we learned together, that when we ascend to heaven, you are there. And when we descend to hell, you are there too. And we're going to stay connected at all times. We're going to have that connectivity. We're never disconnected. So through those people who live this way, when they have that shnei bekios, when they have that two types of expertise, when I'm in a high, I'm connected to you. When I'm in a low, I'm also connected to you. That's precious because we're able to reveal Hashem's greatness in that moment too, in both those moments. Alkein ein la'adam niyayesh etzmo. We shouldn't despair at all for even one moment. Miliz hakarev la'avodat Hashem. From the closeness that we can become, that we could attain and feel when we feel distant, in those times of distance. Why? Because through our many blemishes, which we just spoke about in Rav Nesson's prayers, Avshi Hirbava, and through the seemingly bad and the distance that we create with us and Hashem. Kiadabar Adarabamanu. We shouldn't dwell on this. We shouldn't be despair. We shouldn't despair on this, on our sins, on our blemishes. Rather, on the contrary, specifically from those places, are we able to merit this closeness with Hashem that has never existed before. Aval ikar his karbus harachokim Hashem isbrach u'ayde sadikei hador, and through this closeness that we could attain, through those times of distance, through those times that it seems like there's a mechitza between us and Hashem. How do we do this? We need a shachin. Sometimes we need a shachin. We mamash need a shachin, but we also need a shachin like a tzaddik that's able to guide us and that's able to give us the pointers. On step here, go this way, go that route. We know on a hike in Eretz Yisrael or around the world, they have like those pointers. You know, and the tzaddik gives us those pointers. They've been there before. So we should merit to find those tzaddikim in our lives, whether they're alive today or whether they're from years ago. But mamash, find those pointers in our lives to keep us going, to give us chizik, tremendous chizik, to never stop revealing our greatness. Because revealing our greatness in every way, shape, or form, no matter where we find ourselves, when we're squished, when we're upright, when we're bent, Gevalt is a beautiful thing and is cherished by Hashem. Questions, comments, please feel free.
Jack, you're mamash a shadchan. Like, you're a tzaddik. I'm not joking. You keep me so strong.
I'm so happy. So happy, BH. BH, Mama, we're on this journey together. We're on this journey. We're not stopping. We're not stopping now. We're keep on
No.
going. Keep on going. Keep on dreaming. All right, Tamar, thank you so much. Thank you so
All
much. And I'll
right.
see you soon, okay?
I'll see
I still
you.
have 2 bottles in the freezer, by the way.
I'm not really. Wait, how were they though?
So
They're
good.
good.
Strong.
Okay. I'm gonna be gone for Sukkot, so after
Okay,
Sukkot
but
I'll
they're
make
in the
more
freezer. They're
challahs.
in the freezer, but they're at the Shem.
Thank God.
All right, have an amazing night. We'll be in touch.
Bye, have a good night.
Bye-bye. Bye.